myself Aditya Chakraborty. Today I am going to discuss about the DC generator part 2. The first slide is about the open circuit characteristics and critical resistance of a DC generator. In this image we can see there is a graph between field current and no load armature voltage, that is the induced EMF, and there is a blue colored graph is plotted. This graph is known as open circuit characteristics curve or magnetizing curve, and a tangent is drawn from the P point to the initial point of the graph. This shows the field resistance line. Now we have to discuss the OCC characteristics and critical resistance from this graph. So open circuit characteristics is also known as magnetizing characteristics or magnetic characteristics or no load saturation characteristics or magnetic saturation characteristics. These characteristics shows the relation between generated or induced EMF at no load, that is E0, and the field current, that is IF, at a constant given speed. From this graphical representation, we can see that if the field current is increased, then the no load armature voltage or the generated EMF is also increased. But the magnetizing curve or the open circuit characteristics curve is not started from the origin O. It is started from the A point. Due to residual magnetism, when the current or field current is zero, the value of induced voltage is not zero. Due to residual magnetism, there is a voltage is induced when there is no field current is supplied to the field. For that very reason, the magnetizing characteristics is not starting from the origin or the initial point O. Now the critical resistance. What is critical resistance? Critical resistance means the resistance at which there is no field excitation is possible. That means at which resistance there is no field current is flowing through the field winding. It is known as critical resistance. So after drawing the OCC curve, then tangent is drawn to its initial portion, that is O. The slope of the curve gives the critical resistance. The value of the resistance represented by the tangent to the curve is known as critical resistance for a given speed. This speed is known as the critical speed of generator. So from the OCC we can calculate the critical resistance or the critical speed, and OCC stands for open circuit characteristics of DC generator. Now the next slide is armature reaction. What is armature reaction? Armature reaction is reaction between two magnetic flux. One is armature flux, another is main flux between north and south pole. The armature reaction simply shows the effect of armature field on the main field. When the armature is connected to the external load circuit by the brush or external load resistance, then a current will flow through the armature winding, and hence a magnetic field is produced along the armature conductor. This is known as the armature flux, which opposes the main field flux between north and south pole. So it weakens the main field flux. Then the induced EMF is also reduced, because if the main field flux is weak, then the rate of change of flux is also reduced or decreased. For that very reason, the induced EMF in the armature is also reduced. So in other words, the armature reaction represents the impact of the armature flux on the main field flux. The armature field is produced by the armature conductor when current flows through them, and the main field is produced by the magnetic poles, that means the pole pair, that means north pole and south pole. So the magnetic lines of force is produced between north pole and south pole. Now the next part is MNA. MNA stands for magnetic neutral axis. It is maybe defined as the axis along which no EMF is generated in the armature conductor as they move parallel to the flux lines. That means in that axis there is no EMF is induced. And GNA means, GNA stands for geometrical neutral axis, may be defined as the axis which is perpendicular to the stator field axis. In ideal condition, the GNA and MNA are coincide with each other. But due to the armature reaction, the MNA shift from GNA at an angle of theta. So the brushes are always placed along the MNA because reversal of current in the armature conductor takes place along the axis of MNA, and brush collect the current from commutator and supply it to the external resistance or external load resistance, and commutator makes the alternating current into direct current, or it convert the alternating current into direct current. So the MNA has to be at the brush axis, that means brushes are always placed along the MNA. Now the next slide is the effect of armature reaction. At first, the armature reaction weakens the main flux because the armature flux cut the main field flux or opposes the main field flux. In case of a DC generator, weakening of the main flux reduces the generated voltage. An armature reaction distorts the main flux. Hence, the position of MNA gets shifted. As I have already told, brushes should be placed on the MNA, otherwise it will lead to sparking at the surface of brushes. So due to armature reaction, it is hard to determine the exact position of the MNA. That means if the armature current is increased, then the armature flux is also increased. And if the armature flux is increased, it will oppose the main field flux more. So the angle between GNA and MNA is also increased. That means there is more armature reaction. So we can't actuate the position of the brass because the MNA axis is not fixed. Okay, so it is very hard to determine the exact position of the actual magnetic neutral axis. So these are the Hertz effect of armature reaction. Now the next slide is interpole and compensating winding. So the interpoles and compensating winding are used to minimize the armature reaction. If we placed another winding in close proximity of the armature winding, and if it is carrying the same current but in opposite direction as that of the armature conductor, then this will nullify the armature field. That means we have to connect the compensating winding in series with the armature winding, but in opposite phase or in out of phase. Such an additional winding is called compensating winding, and it is placed on the pole faces. Compensating winding is connected in series with the armature winding, as I've already told, in such a way that it carries the current in opposite direction. Now the interpoles. You can see the image of interpole and compensating winding here. So what is interpoles? Interpoles are the small auxiliary poles placed between the main field poles. Winding on the interpoles is connected in series with the armature. Each interpole is wound in such a way that its magnetic polarity is same as that of the main pole ahead of it. Interpoles nullify the quadrature axis armature flux. That means interpole is used to minimize the armature reaction, and as well as the compensating winding is also used to reduce the armature reaction of a DC machine. Now the next slide is commutation. So what is commutation? Commutation is done by the commutator or the rotating rectifier in the DC machine. So commutation in DC machine is a process in which generated alternating current in the armature winding of a DC machine is converted into direct current after going through the commutator and the stationary brushes. It will take place, the coil undergoing commutation is short circuited by the brushes. That means the brushes are always connected with the commutator, and the current is flowing through the armature. When it has come to the commutator, then there is a summation of current in the commutator which is supplied to the brass. Why there is a summation of current? Because the brass axis is placed along the MNA. So there are two conductors along the brass. One is in N pole side and one is at S pole side. So we know that the direction of current is just opposite with each other in North pole and South pole. So in the brass axis, the summation of two current we can get, and this will flow through the brass to the external load circuit. That means the alternating current is converted into the direct current. The brief period during which the coil remains short circuited is known as TC, that is the commutation time. Short circuited with which part? Short circuited with the brushes. If the current reversal is completed by the end of TC, it is called ideal commutation. If the commutation time is TC, end of TC, then it is ideal commutation. And if the current reversal is not completed by that time, then there is a arcing or sparking occurs between the brushes and the commutator, which results the damage of the each part, that means the damage of commutator and the brushes. Here we can see the five images of the commutation. The first image, we can see the armature windings are connected with the commutator segments, and two current, these are IC, in reverse direction are come to the commutator segment B, and we can get the summation of two currents, that is 2IC, and which is supplied to the brass, and from brass which is supplied to the external load circuit. And the same thing is happening in figure 2, figure 3, 4, 5, 6. Here are 5 picture. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Each figure consists the same thing. That means when the armature is rotating, then the commutator is also rotating, and the same number of current is flowing through the brush to the external load circuit, that is the direct current, which is converted in commutator, and that is known as the commutation. So by this process, the alternating current is converted into the direct current. This is the very important part, that is commutation. Now the next slide is the application of DC generator. The application of different types of DC generator include the following. Number one, the separately excited DC generator. Separately excited, that means the field is excited by some external source or external DC source, that is the separately excited DC generator, is used for boosting as well as electropeating. Boosting means the boost up of voltage, and electroplating, it is used in power and lighting purpose using field regulators. Number two, the self-excited DC generator or shunt DC generator is used for power as well as ordinary lighting using the regulator. That means for regulation and for regulatory supplying voltage, or for regulated supply voltage, the DC shunt generator is used, and for power supply also it is used. It can be used for battery lighting. Number three, the series DC generator. Series DC generator means where the field winding is connected in series with the armature, and shunt generator means where the field winding is connected in parallel with the armature. So the series DC generator is used in arc lamp for lighting, and stable current generator and booster. And at last, the compound DC generator. The compound DC generator is mainly used to provide the power supply for the DC welding machine, or you can say for the DC arc welding machine, where the electric arc is used for welding purpose, to weld two metallic part or two metallic plate, that is the DC welding machine. So these are the application of DC generator. Okay.